Welcome to this demonstration video on the New South Wales Online Registry. This demonstration will briefly step you through the online process for issuing a subpoena on one or several recipients. If you're representing yourself in a case, you will not be able to complete this process online. This is because you must first obtain leave from the court to issue a subpoena on any person. If you're representing yourself and need assistance, you should contact the specific registry in which your case is being heard. A subpoena is used to request a person bring certain documents or items before the court hearing. The subpoena will be listed in court so that appropriate access orders can be made. If you need to issue the same type of subpoena multiple times in the one proceeding, you can do this quickly and efficiently online without having to search for the case repeatedly. This option will be demonstrated later in this video. In this example, we'll step through the process for filing a subpoena to produce items before hearing or UCPR Form 26A. If you require additional legal support, please contact Law Access New South Wales or see information about subpoenas on the Law Assist website. As this form is filed on an existing case, the case information is pre-populated. Scroll down to the subpoena recipient information. Here, you must enter the name and service address of the subpoena recipient. The subpoena recipient is the person who has to produce or supply the documents or items to the court by the date you specify. Once you've entered the subpoena recipient details, you need to select the proposed access order details from the drop-down list. For this example, we'll use the first access plaintiff. If you want to propose an order other than what is in the list, you will need to file the subpoena at the registry. Next, select the listing date for the subpoena. This is the date upon which you either expect the subpoena recipient to return the material to court or appear to contest the subpoena. It's important that the date you select here is identical to the date on the document you've already prepared. If you're issuing a subpoena in the District or Supreme Court, you may select any day of the week, excluding public holidays and court vacation periods. This is because the Supreme and District Court hold a subpoena list each day. However, in the local court, subpoena matters are only heard on certain days of the week. Be sure you know which day the listing court hears subpoena matters. If you choose the incorrect date, the registrar may not deal with the matter on the day you've selected. If you're unsure about which day or date to select, please contact the registry before proceeding. Click Next to continue. You will need to upload a signed, completed version of UCPR Form 26A. Your completed form should state the listing date, time, place, and the last date for service of the subpoena. Please note that the subpoena you upload must contain the same information you entered in the online form. And you should ensure that you've inserted the last day for service of the subpoena on the recipient in accordance with Part 33 of the Uniform Civil Procedure Rules, if the recipient is located in New South Wales, or Part 3 of the Service and Execution of Process Act, if the recipient is located elsewhere in Australia. If you have left this date blank, you can save the online form as a draft, then update the document you've created. Click Attach. Then click Browse. Locate and then select the signed PDF version of the subpoena form. Then click Open. Click Attach. When the subpoena has been attached, click Next to continue. You now have the option to fill out another subpoena of the same type on this case, or continue to payment. If you click Fill out another subpoena, you will be taken to the start of the online form. There is currently no limit to the quantity of subpoenas that can be filed online, so you may repeat these steps as many times as required for that case. To pay for the subpoena form or any additional forms filed, click Forms Awaiting Payment. Your forms are now awaiting payment. Please note that your forms have not been submitted to the court until that payment is made. To complete the payment and submit the forms, select the forms. Then click Next. This will step you through our secure credit card payment facility. Once your payment has been received, it should only take a few minutes for the court to formally approve your submission, although in some instances it may take up to 10 minutes. When approved, you will receive an email to confirm your submission. Thank you for taking the time to view this demonstration. We hope it's helped guide you through this form. More forms will be made available over time, so please keep an eye on the New South Wales Online Registry homepage for the latest updates.